Welcome to our lecture about internet weaknesses and targets. Today we want to speak about the internet, the World Wide Web, and give a survey about the technologies behind. This is the lecture series content table. We are in the chapter speaking in the introductory chapter. Last time we spoke about, gave an overview about internet security, and today we want to give an overview about internet technology and web systems. Then later we will speak about risk analysis, and then the main part, the main topic of the lecture is this internet weakness and targets. Then we have a lot of lectures about that. So, let's start with the internet. Everyone knows internet, everyone knows the World Wide Web. If you look, then today about 1 billion hosts all over the world are connected to the internet. They are able to exchange information by the internet. So all places in the world are connected. Everyone knows how internet is changing our society. And of course, the more important information exchanged via the internet, the more tasks people using the internet, e-business, buying books, buying other things, changing information, the more security becomes important. So security is more and more a key factor for using internet and World Wide Web. But to understand the security issues, to discuss problems, weaknesses of the internet protocols, of the different applications, before one can do this, one needs to understand network technology. One needs to understand how internet is working. One needs to understand the web technologies. And exactly that's the reason that we have to start our lecture series about internet security by having a closer look to the internet and to the World Wide Web to understand the various security problems occurring around the use of internet and World Wide Web. To understand how attackers, how hackers try to attack a system, try to get access, for example, to secret information or to misuse other identities in the internet. To understand such different threat scenarios and attack methods, it is important to understand the internet technology. And, of course, to develop protection mechanisms against such attacks. It needs an understanding of the internet protocols, of the internet technology, of the network technology, and of the mechanisms that are used in the different internet applications. So let's start to have a look, a closer look to the internet. You know, internet is a network of network. It's a network of computer networks. Each of these networks, for example here, our HPI network or the network at home, they may be connected by means of internet technology. In this sense, the internet is a virtual network. Let's have a closer look to computer networks. Computer networks consists of different components. Of course, it consists of computers. These are the computers that are exchanging information, that exchanging, that communicating via the network. And if we look to the way how these computers interact to each other, we can differentiate between two types of computers. There is one type called the server, and the server is providing resources, for example, documents, for example, computational or storage resources. So they are waiting for requests to provide their resources. And the other type of computers or systems in a network are the clients. And the clients, these are the active part. They make active use of the resources offered by the servers. Now you cannot see, you cannot think that in a computer networks, you can exactly say this is a server computer or this is a client computer. This differentiation depends from a concrete communication activity. So a computer can be in the same moment in one communication, the server component, and in the other communication, the client component. This server-client model was designed to help to understand the very complex task of a communication of computer systems. So speaking about computer networks, so on the one side we have the computers as one of the components. The other component are the transmission media. Could be different types, it could be a cable, it could be other physical media, it could be radio waves or light or other things. So a media that connects the different computers so that they are able to exchange signals, the signals that code the messages the computers want to exchange. So, and we have wired transmission media, for example, twisted pair, coaxial cable, optical fiber, and others. And we have wireless transmission media, radio waves, infrared signals, and others. And the third component of computer networks is consisting of are the infrastructure components. These infrastructure components are network adapters or network interfaces. By means of these network interfaces, the signals, the bits which encode a message, are transformed into physical signals. For example, if a cable is used, then this network adapter transforms bits into electrical signals, so the signals that can be transmitted via the transmission media to another computer. So computers, transmission media, and infrastructure components, these are the components of a computer network. So the communication within a computer network needs to be ruled in a very fine, up to a very fine grade of details. And the network systems, the network communication system is it's called network protocols, and these network protocols they rule all the communication all the tasks that are needed to make communication possible. So if we have a look here to the large amount of network protocols, this map is not necessary to understand in detail, it's only to illustrate that there are many, many details that need to be ruled. Protocol is responsible to do this, to make communication within a computer network possible. So, for example, these network protocols, they have to rule the format of the transmitted messages. Network protocols have to define an address schema to address, for example, a host to address the computer message is sent to. Or the network protocols have to exactly rule each possible step in the communication process and the methods for controlling whether this communication process works correctly. So these network protocols is something like the computational system of a network.